شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. This is juz number 10, and what happens is Allah talks about the fact that there are many logistics on the Battle of Badr, which if anyone started to comprehend from before, they will not be able to actually make the same result come about. So Allah made the Prophet see, and He made the Muslims see the enemies as less, and He made the enemies see the Muslims as double. And this He mentioned right at the beginning of it, and He says that how He brought weakness to the hearts of those who were the enemies of the Muslims in the Prophet's time, because they had the shaitan, they had the devil behind them. But it warns us that our problem is going to be if we start to quarrel with one another and fall apart with one another. This is ayah number 46. He mentions us not to go down that pathway. And one of the reasons why we may go down that pathway is because of the munafiqs, or the people who are hypocrites amongst us, who are always trying to make us feel that, you know, this is the right type of iman that they've got, which is, you know, half, kind of half. And Allah tells us not to follow that, and tells us that change will only come about in this ummah if we make the change within ourselves. And this is ayah number 53. So Allah Azza wa Jal tells us that we've got to always prepare for those people who may want to sort of tether this religion away. This is ayah number 60, but it tells us also to try and engage with them. And the engagement with them is that we've got to also be able to trust them and trust those people who are maybe enemies towards Islam. This is ayah number 61, you will find that. Allah tells us that, look, we have got weakness amongst us, but one of the greatest weakness may be that we may go towards the worldly things that are here. This is ayah number 67. And this was one of the reasons why the punishment of Allah almost came onto the Muslims in that time. And it divides the Muslims in many different sections of how we may actually help Allah and His Messenger, because there are those people who will help the Muslims as well, and there are those people who will only look after themselves. If you want to read about this, you will find it towards the end of Suratul Anfal. Surah Tawbah starts a quarter of the way of this juz. And the Surah Tawbah starts off by telling us, and this is there's a specific context for this. The context is that Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has come to the end of his life, and he sees that the polytheists of his time, they need to be they need to have a moment to remove themselves, to think about Islam. If they accept it, they accept it. Otherwise, they remove themselves from this vicinity and from this part. Then Allah tells us that these are the people. Now, there's a lot of parts in this surah that tells us about the munafiqs and the hypocrites, because they caused a lot of problems for the Muslims. And today, the same thing is happening, that there are hypocrites that are causing these problems amongst us. And it tells us to be wary of them. So two things. One is those enemies outside who are trying to always make, you know, things and laws against us. And if you look at specifically, you will find Allah says that just because a person is holding the keys to the Kaaba, or looking after the Kaaba, or a holy place, doesn't mean that they're close to Allah. This is ayah number 19. Ayah number 20, and you will find that Allah tells us that the real people are those who strive in the path of Allah with their wealth and with their selves, and they get the best portion of this. Thereafter, Allah tells us that to be careful, because our own family ties and the wealth of this world, the houses that we've got, these things could actually lead us away from Allah. This is ayah number 34. Ayah number 35 onwards, it tells us not to become those people who are in ourselves, believe so much in ourselves that we forget about Allah's power behind us. It is only Allah's power that will make us people who are victorious. So a great part of this surah is to do with the munafiqeen. And if you look in ayah number 43 onwards, he tells us that these people, they want to go with the Muslims when they think the benefit of the Muslims are there, and they want to move away from, you know, all of this and sit back and relax and watch the Muslims getting hurt when they think that the Muslims are going to lose. And all of this is stretching across ayah number 40 to about 50. And they come with many different excuses. to the Prophet ﷺ, that their wealth or their children are the very reasons that they couldn't come out to be with the Prophet ﷺ when it's the tough times to go and challenge these people. They even will take oaths and they'll say that, you know, we are with you. But all these oaths and so on don't save them when it comes to, or don't show the truth when it comes to the actual part of showing the service to Allah Azza wa Jal. So Allah tells us that what will happen in the end is when the booty comes. This is what happened. The booty came and these munafiqs stood up and said, look, give us the booty now. We're always Muslims. So when it comes to the booty, they want their share. But when it comes to actually fighting or striving or getting up and doing something for their own kind, they won't be there. In fact, they actually hurt the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam by making certain comments about him, by making certain comments about the believers, by even going to the extent of making their own groups. And while they're in the masjid, they start with their eyes looking at the Sahaba and start saying, look, what did he bring? What did he bring to as a means of sadaqah to help the Muslims? So they look down upon the Muslims who actually give small amounts of sadaqah towards the cause of Allah and His Messenger. All of this you will find towards the end of the surah. And Allah Azza wa Jal tells us that these are the people whom Allah warns. He says, even if the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was to make istighfar, if he was to make actually, you know, if he was to say, oh Allah, forgive these people, Allah says that I won't forgive, you know, these people because of what they've actually done. They make certain plots against the Muslims while they stay amongst the Muslims. Now, the reason why Allah is telling us this is because there are Muslims amongst us who've got Muslim names, who've got Muslim, you know, appearances, or Muslim, they're with the Muslims, and they're giving many, many different, you know, oaths to say that they're with the support of the Muslims and so on. But in the end, they don't actually support the Muslims. They are there to support the those who are the enemies of the Muslims. So, if you look in ayah number 80, 82 and so on, Allah Azza wa Jalla says, well, they were the people who sat there in the first place. So let them carry on sitting there, because, and don't make an excuse to say that, oh, how comes that these munafiqs, they don't actually support the Muslims, but they still have got so much wealth and they've got children as well. Allah says, I will make that a punishment on them in the end. And Allah says that the real ones are those who will strive. And a lot of this, what this juz or this Surah Tawbah is telling us is to stand up and to strive, even if we have little means with ourselves when it comes to Allah's cause, when it comes to Allah's way, to get up and to be with those. If we make any excuses, and this is specifically Allah saying, there's any excuses that we make, Allah knows about those excuses. And this is right at the end of the juz. And those, there are people who had little, but they still came with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, tried to go with him. But when the Prophet couldn't take them because they had little means with them, they turned around with tears flowing down their eyes that they couldn't join the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And they were poor people. But there are others who are known Muslims, who said they're Muslims, but they're really munafiqs. They had a lot of wealth and so on, but they failed to come out with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So what this tells us is whether you have wealth or whether you don't have wealth is not what Allah is looking for. Allah is looking for the service. Allah is looking for us to respond. And to respond in a way that whether we have little means or large, Allah doesn't care about that. He wants to see whether we're actually saying labbaik, whether we're saying we're here for the cause, and whether we're ready to come out and to do our best, you know, for the cause, whatever that cause may be. And right at the end, Allah Azza wa Jal says that, you know, not to even look down on those sahaba, those people who had little means, but they tried to help in the great cause. Jazakumullah khair wa akhir da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
ذكر علم ونور الحاملات سلوا ونور والرسمات هنا سرور يا حلوى تلك السنين.